Hello beautiful people, you are welcome to another edition of Golden Stitches. Forgive me for not dropping videos since. Is that okay? For those that subscribe, I really want to say I appreciate you for your show of love. I want to thank you for all your comments and subscription. Thank you very much. I love you all. Alright, so today I'll be teaching how to cut 6 pieces blouse using pattern. Is that okay? So I want us to first of all draft the pattern before you can now use this pattern to cut on your fabric. Now if you are not really used to it, if you cut on your fabric you are going to have issues, so that is why I would prefer that you do it first on your pattern paper. Okay, so let's get started. As usual, we need our marker, the ruler, arm hook off, is that okay, scissors, then tape. All right, so let's get started. So what I did is I pre-marked all the lines. So this is our shoulder line, the bust point. This is the under bust, the waistline. Then this is the full length. This is the full length. Full length. All right. So let's get started. So the normal measurements you need is the passing bust point, the waist, then the under bust. Is that okay? Then you need the full length. For this particular one, I used 24 inches as my full length. Is that okay? See it? I used 24 inches as the full length of my blouse. Okay, so the next thing you have to consider is the nipple to nipple, the distance between the nipple to nipple. Yes, you understand? So I'm going to take, for example, the client I'm cutting for is 8 inches, so which is 4, but I cannot just go and cut the 4. I have to cut 4.5 because of the joining that will be happening there. So I'm going to measure the 4.5 on the bust point. I'll measure it on the under bust, then I'll measure it on the waist. I know some of you ask what of the full length. No, don't worry, when we get there I'll tell you what will happen there. All right, so then you do the same thing on the shoulder line here. So let's take our ruler and join them together. So I'm going to join it from the shoulder line down to the waistline. All right, so now that we have done that, we're going to measure on the waistline, measure 1 inch. Inward, then on the under bust the same thing, 1 inch. Then when you get to the bust point, take 1/2 inch upward, 1/2 inch downward. All right, then you are going to go to the shoulder line, then you come in by 1 inch, sorry, 1/2 inch, sorry. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is I'm going to blend this line. So I'm going to take this line here now from my shoulder line, blend it to the 1/2 inch on the upper side. All right, so once I've done that, then you're going to blend this one. So I'm joining all the lines together now. Is that okay? So after you've done that, now you know that at this point here, if it's a bust here now, you know I can just curve it to give me that breast shape, but because I don't want it to be that, to give me that pointed edge, I'm just going to blend it this way. Is that okay? So I'll just blend it into the line because I don't want it to give me a sharp edge. So I'm just blending it now. So all right, after I've done that, now to the full length here, now I'm going to take 7 inches. Now this 7 inches, it depends on how wide you want your fillet to come out in your 6 pieces that you want to cut. Is that okay? So I'm going to take 7 inches here, then I'm just going to blend. I'm going to join it to the waist, point here this way. So after I've done that, I'll just cut it out so that we use this side to cut the side piece. Alright, so once I opened it, this is what it looks like. Is that okay? So once you fold it, this is what you have. So I'm going to use this now to cut the side. So I've taken my center piece here, which is this one, placed it on a fresh pattern paper because I want to cut the side right now. So the first thing I'm going to do is to, I'm going to trace here out. Alright, so what is going to happen right now? I've already gone over this, but I want to go over it in a more clearer. So after you have traced this curve, because this curve, it must rhyme with the middle of where you are going to join it. Is that okay? So that is the essence of tracing this curve. So once you've traced this curve, you are now going to start imputing your measurements. That is 16, which is 8. If you measure here now, you can see it's 4. Take the 4 out. Where is your 8? Mark it. You can see this is where the 8 is. Can you see it? Alright, then add 2 inches to it. Allowance. Yeah, okay. Please ignore this line, please. Ignore this line. Is that okay? Then once you have done that, just draw it down. Okay. So after you have done that, the next thing is the bust point. Where is the person's bust point? You are going to calculate the person's bust point. Now for this case is 10.5. 10.7, I mean. But if you look at this place, what you have here is what? The bust point is 4.5. So remove that 4.5. Then take the remaining measurement, 10.7, which is this place. Is that okay? Then I'm going to add allowance. I just add 3-inch allowance because there'll be a lot of joining. So make sure you add a lot of allowance. Is that okay? So this is it. Then the waist is what? 9.5. The waist is 9.5. Now, if you look at this place, the waist here is 3.5 that is remaining after cutting. So I'm going to take the 3.5 out. Then I'm going to mark my 9.5. Can you see it? Already marked it at 9.5. So I'll be adding. Okay, this 2 inches is okay. Alright. Then I'm going to come here. You can see what we added was 7. Then I'm going to mark, because I don't want it to be too bulky, I'll mark 13.5 instead of finishing the line. Is that okay? So let's join the lines together now. I'm cross checking. This is 10.7. And this is our allowance. Alright. So I'm joining everything now together. Okay, so what will happen now, as we are coming this way, coming down this way. I'm going to blend it to give it a shape. I'm just shaping it out. Then for the armhole, you are going to take the midpoint. This 8.5, which is 4.25. Take the midpoint, go in by 1/2 inch. I'm going to use my curve to get it. Okay, then once you have done this, you can now cut out. So this is the front, then this is the front side. So this is what it's going to look like. Are you seeing it? You can see that this side, it will rhyme by the time you are sewing it. Okay, so now we are going to use this to cut the back. So once we've done that, it's just a little modification which I'll be showing you how to modify it now when I after tracing it on the pattern paper. So just keep washing and make sure you wash to the end. Okay, so I've gone ahead to measure 2 inches for the zipper allowance. All right, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to place the front, the center front on this pattern, then I'll just, like I did before, trace and mark it out, then cut it out. Then I'll just show you the difference between the back and this front, the modification I told you people about. I'll be showing you here now. So after I've done that, let's cut it out. Make sure you mark all this side so that you know where to cut when the time comes, when you are trimming it. So I'm just going to cut it out now. So this is the back plus the allowance. So I'm going to keep this aside and cut the side so that I'll show it to you once. Alright, so on the side there, I'll be adding 2 inches. Do you understand? I made the modification or cut the side. I want to add 2 inches to the allowance to the side. Is that okay? So let's just mark these 2 inches. After we have marked that 2 inches, then I'm going to keep this one aside. Please, this one here. Then transfer all these lines. You see where the waist stop? So this is the bust. Where our waist is stopping here like this. That is where we are going to modify. Is that okay? So on this waist here, we are going to take our ruler. We are going to keep it straight like this. Are you seeing it? So we're going to draw a line like this. Can you see it? Then I'm going to trim this bustier area out because I don't need it for the back. So you can see that the back is now straight. So we have eliminated, instead of going through all those measurements and everything, so you just use the back to trace it and get rid of the bustier area. Now we are going to do the same thing for the side. Let's keep this one aside for the side. I'm going to trim, I'm going to cut this one up now. Okay, at least 2 inches. Don't know me now, cut the back. The same thing I did to this, the other, the back, by removing the bustier area. I'm going to repeat the same thing here. Make sure your line is straight. Just take it this way. So, I'm going to trim it now. Now, if I was the one doing it, I can just use this and put my allowances on when I'm cutting the fabric. But so that you will understand what I'm doing, I'm going to use another pattern paper to show you what I'm talking about. At this side, we need to add allowance. You know, this is the, we use the front to trace the back. So we must put allowance for the back here, at this point here, this side here. So I'm going to bring another pattern paper. So I've retraced the back. Is that okay? So this is the bustier place that we are going to cut at the end of the day. That I've cut, but because I retraced it, I have to just show it so that you know that here is not part of it. So now I'm going to show you how to add the allowance in the back. You are going to come to the shoulder place area like this. You add your 2 inches. Then I'm going to bring this front back. Then you are going to mark your waistline this way. Mark it out, trace it, and mark it. So once you have done that, this is your 2-inch line. You are going to draw it straight to the waistline here. So putting our patterns together, this is going to be the front side for the side. Then this is the back center with zipper allowance. Then this is the back. So you have plain places so you see it. So this is what it will look like at the end of the day. This for the back. Is that okay? And this is for the front. I'll open it now. Exactly. So I'll be showing you how to. The next thing is to show you how to cut it using fabric. Alright, so thank you for watching. In the next video, as like I said, I'll be showing you how to couple, use this to cut and couple the blouse. Thank you for watching. If this video was of any help, give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.